Okay, so the difference between sort of substance and sort of process addictions, and like, which for me is like a substance, it could be food or alcohol, or a person, you know, like a romantic thing or a special person. And then for me, actually the things are pretty much the same in letting them go, except that I know from my own experience that the ego is often more clever in rationalizing getting back with a person than it is with stopping, say, donuts or alcohol or cocaine. So it can come up with greater rationalizations to pick up. So to pick up, you know, to pick up the phone or whatever, than with, you know, than a thing. So obviously with the sort of like romantic obsession and stuff like that, you know, there is the fellowships that they can be a good guide. Having guides who give you clear bottom lines around that, and having that support of a person saying, because if you're left in your head alone, often the head will rationalize a reason to contact. Or, but also I think with a person, just a lot of the same things apply. You know, if I had a lot of romantic obsession with someone, for me, I think the thing to be doing is, one of the first key things is to realize that the amount of airtime that I give that person in my head is the buildup of the attachment. So that's the first thing. So every second I think of that person is like, it's already growing a spiritual, it's energetic momentum within the ego. So at a certain point, if you just go keep in fantasy for long enough, oh, it'd be so nice to meet them, it'd be so nice to text them, it'd be so nice to pick up the phone to them. Even if you're not doing it, every second you're in your head, it's like that attachment is building up. So in 12 steps, we'd say the level of powerlessness to act out, you know, the defense is going. So if I spent like, even if I'm doing this thing, shall I call them, shall I not call them? Shall I call them, shall I not call them? Well, it's no harm even to think about them today, you know. That there's no harm in that, because I'm not harming them by calling them, or I'm not harming them by not calling them. But all of that is like, it's a disconnection from source, and it's building up an energetic momentum. And at a certain point, it's like there's a lapse, and you're picking up the phone. You know, and it's just happened, and you didn't realize it's happened. So that's the first thing, is like, knowing that is very powerful, because it's like, you know, you could say, I go to a fellowship where they say, with people, they say, like, not to do it for more than 3 seconds, but I try not to do it for more than as little time as possible, because each thought, if you spent like 3 or 4 days continuously trying to think about them and not think about them, then, you know, that level of powerlessness, because the attachment, the energetic momentum of that is building up. The thing, of course, then to do with me, with a person, you know, is if I... now, this is controversial. You can or not do it. I mean, it may be better not to look at them. I mean, one of the things I've done... so it's a risky thing. So do it or not do it. Probably not do it, but you can do it if you feel drawn to doing it. It's like if I had a photo of that person, let's say I was really had this crush on this woman, and I have a photo of her or something, then I would get the photo, I'd look and put it on the table, and then look at the photo of the woman for 1 second and do the Course in Miracles exercise on it. This woman is just as meaningless as the lamp, which is just as meaningless as the ceiling colour, which is just as meaningless as that pillow, which is just as meaningless as the green plant behind me. Each thing's for 1 second. And I'd be like, I'd keep doing it, and it'd be like the need to go back and look at that for longer, or to like, this, well, I'd rather look at the picture of the woman than the green plant, you know? So it's like, well, obviously, each time if I'm doing that, like, you know, maybe 3 times a day, then I'd be like looking at my track. Every day I'm doing it religiously, and it's like, okay, well, you know, that and there's a thing in consciousness where when you see something meaningless, you just let it go very, very effortlessly, and there's no need to go back. It loses its magical pull. So I'd be doing that and I'd be like tracking, like, okay, well, today was the first day and it was very difficult to do that. And I just wanted to, and the course says you have to spend an equal amount of time on each thing. Mm-hmm. So like when I get, if I was to get obsessed with someone, then it'd be like, I just want to look at them and think about them nonstop. And so it's a break of the addiction to look at now the lab for 1 second and then look at something else and say, you know, the woman is meaningless. The camera is meaningless. That pink shawl is meaningless. You know, so whatever it is, you know, you look around, you know, these are the objects that go, the plant is meaningless. The teddy bear is meaningless. So it's like all of those things. So I'd be doing that. But it's the regular practice which is breaking it down. And then you're tracking, like, when a thing loses its magical thing. Like, I used to be, I've been in a position of neutrality around donuts for many years. You know, even if people want to put a bag of donuts. Like, there's no more, like, in the early days, I'm sure I'd be, like, looking. Or even if I'm not looking, I'll be forcing myself not to look, but I'll still be having it in my head that there are donuts on the table. So it's like you want to get that with the person that's magical. Mm. Also, things like, you know, I've worked on it as well. I realized that you're picking up collective belief systems around it. So like, you know, I've shared, you know, I've watched lots of Disney films where I will say I pick up the archetype that I'm the woman. And I'm waiting for a woman in shining armor to come and rescue me. So that's like an archetypal program that I picked up from just being alive and watching all these Hollywood movies and everything. So if there's any other belief systems, and of course in miracles, nothing outside of you can fix you. But, mm-hmm. but what belief systems am I programmed with, and just deleting those? Another thing you could do is any magical properties. You could cancel the magical properties. Well, you know, I cancel my belief that her hair is amazing. Or I cancel my belief that she's so intelligent. I'm an infinite being. So you can also go to town, not just on a general thing, but on specific things that the ego has projected as being special. But keep doing it. I would keep doing all the different things. If there's like feelings, like if I had lust, I'd sit with the lust until it passes. Like this if there's a craving energy, or if I have a craving to pick up the phone and call them, then I'd let go of the thought and just try and feel that energy in my body until it's totally dissipated. Because often, it's like an urge to make contact. So I just feel out the urge until there's no urge left. And also cancel any thoughts I have around the person, not give time, and delete any aspects which I think are either projections that I've made magical or special in the person, and also tune back into what are the collective programs that I'm picking up from the collective unconscious. You know, that this is the knight in shining armor, or this is the person, you know, I cancel my belief there is such a thing as a person in shining armor that's going to rescue me and fix everything. So you delete those, and that will dissolve, you know, the underpinnings of the thing.